लॉस ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन. देर आर टू लॉस ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन. द फर्स्ट वन इज द इंसिडेंट रे, द रिफ्रैक्टेड रे एंड द नॉर्मल ऑल लाई इन द सेम प्लेन. यू कैन सी इन दिस फिगर दैट द इंसिडेंट रे, रिफ्रैक्टेड रे एंड दिस नॉर्मल ऑल आर लाइंग इन द सेम प्लेन ऑफ पेपर और पेज और दिस स्क्रीन. नो रे इज आउट ऑफ द प्लेन और नो रे इज इन एन अदर प्लेन. सो ऑल आर लाइंग इन द सेम प्लेन. दिस लॉ इज जस्ट लाइक द लॉ ऑफ रिफ्लेक्शन एज यू हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर. सो एंड द सेकेंड लॉ इज द रेशियो ऑफ द साइन ऑफ द एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस टू द साइन ऑफ द एंगल ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन इज ऑलवेज इक्वल्स टू अ कॉन्स्टेंट. राइट, दिस साइन आई डिवाइडेड बाय साइन आर इज इक्वल्स टू कॉन्स्टेंट एंड दिस कॉन्स्टेंट इज बेसिकली नोन एज रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स. एंड रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज बेसिकली ऑफ द सेकेंड मीडियम विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द फर्स्ट मीडियम. एंड दिस लॉ, दिस सेकेंड लॉ इज ऑल्सो नेम एज स्नेल्स लॉ. स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन अ मीडियम. स्टूडेंट, रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट इज कॉज्ड बाय द डिफरेंस इन स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन डिफरेंट मीडिया. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट इन एयर इज approximately 3×10⁸ meter per second. However, when light travels through a medium such as water or glass, its speed decreases. The speed of light in water is approximately 2.3×10⁸ meter per second, while the speed of light in glass is approximately 2×10⁸ meter per second. So, to describe the change in the speed of light in a medium, we use the term index of refraction or refractive index. Refractive index. The refractive index n of a medium is the ratio of the speed of light c in air to the speed v of light in the medium. You can see that we can calculate refractive index n is equals to speed of light in air divided by speed of light in medium. Total internal reflection. Total internal reflection is the phenomena of complete reflection of a light reaching an interface with a less dense medium when the angle of incidence exceeds the critical angle. You can see in this figure that the ray normal to the surface is not bent. When it moves from a denser medium to a rarer medium, and if this ray is normal to the surface, then it will not bend. It will go straight in the other medium. When the ray is at some angle, then it will bend away from the normal as it moves from a denser medium to a rarer medium. And as the angle of incidence increases, the angle of refraction also increases. And then there comes a certain angle which is called critical angle, for which the refracted angle is 90 degrees. And then there comes an angle which is greater than critical angle, for which the ray is totally reflected back into the same medium and it is not refracted. So this phenomena is called total internal reflection. Total internal reflection. Let us consider these three figures. First of all, look at this figure. When a ray of light traveling in denser medium enters into a rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. Let's say we have an incident ray in the denser medium, that is glass, and it is traveling from a denser medium to air, which is a rarer medium. It will bend away from the normal. You can see that it is bending away from the normal. And if you consider this figure, the angle of incidence that is causing the refracted ray in the rarer medium to bend through 90 degree, this angle is called critical angle. This I is equals to C. When the refracted ray is at 90 degree to the normal, then you can say that your incident ray was making critical angle with the normal. And when the angle of incidence becomes larger than the critical angle, look at this, when the angle of incidence becomes larger than the critical angle, then no refraction will occur, right? The entire light is reflected back into the denser medium, and this is known as total internal reflection. You can see here that no light ray is refracted. Here, angle of incidence is greater than critical angle. So, this was the total internal reflection.